Okay, good morning, everyone, and welcome to Chair Yoga for Body, Soul, and Mind. We'll be starting with our warm-up shortly. I'm Diane. I'll be leading you through this session.
Four, five, six, seven, eight.
shoulder rolls. One, two, three, four. Reverse. One, two, three, four. Inhale, reach, and exhale down. Inhale, stretch, exhale down. Inhale, stretch, exhale down. Inhale, stretch, exhale down. All right, let's work the neck a little bit now. I'm going to take ear to shoulder, and you can gently place the hand over the head and bring it back to center position. Other side, ear to shoulder. Back to center and turn to one side. Come back to center position. Turn to the other side. Come back to center position. Now look behind the shoulder like someone is falling. And other side. And back to center position. I'm going to try to adjust this a little so that you can see my feet.
Three. Come back up
to center position. Inhale, exhale, elbow to thigh. Interlace the fingertips. Lift the outside elbow and inhale. One, two, three. Exhale. One, two, three. Inhale up. Come back to center pose. Bring the feet forward and we will go into chair pose. Hands come down, they slide against the outside and come to waist high. Now just lift the arms only. Hold one, two, three, four, five, six. Exhale. Inhale. Lift the arms. One, two, three, four, five, six. Exhale. Inhale. Lift arms. Hold. One, two, three, four, five, six. Exhale down. All right, now feet slightly more apart. Hands on thighs. You are going to pump the stomach only out and in. All right, ready? We're going to exhale through the mouth. Pull in. Relax. All right, second set. Relax. Second, third set. And inhale up. Exhale down. All right, so now we're going to do eagle pose, and then we're going to take it from the chair to the standing position and combine it with bird dog position. All right, so we start out, arms out to the sides, bend one elbow in, take the other elbow inside. And if everybody here is fine with this, for our viewers, if you can't get the elbows interlaced, just keep them together like so. All right, now grab the hands. We inhale, lift, two, three. Exhale, down, two, three. Inhale, up, two, three. Exhale, down, two, three. Inhale, up, two, three. Exhale, down, two, three. Release. Fingers wide, press to the back wall, and one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. All right, now we're going to try eagle pose with the legs. So you are going to cross one leg over the other. Turn the front foot inward. Press the foot behind the ankle. Or just leave the legs crossed. Inhale up, bend one elbow, come into the other elbow, grab the hands together. Inhale, one, two, three. Exhale, down, two, three. Inhale up, two, three. Exhale, down. Two, three, release. Release the foot from around the ankle. Place it on the floor. We're going to do this on the opposite side. We cross. Turn the front foot inward to the side. Press the foot around the ankle. And now opposite elbow. So bend this elbow, place this elbow inside, grab the hands, inhale, one, two, three, exhale, down, two, three, inhale, up, two, three, exhale, down, two, three, inhale, up, two, three, exhale, down, two, three, release, and take your foot away. All right, now we're going to stand, and I won't ask you to do a standing eagle pose with the legs. That's extremely difficult, but we'll stand, come to the side of the chair. Eagle pose, one elbow inside the other, and grab arm. Now, if you can, slide the foot to the back or not. Your balance is not good. Just leave it here. Inhale. Exhale. Hands, push through, turn to the chair, extend the leg into bird dog. So one leg up, the opposite arm over the chair, and hold, two, three, four, exhale, elbow to knee, and again stretch, one, two, three, four, exhale, elbow to knee, and center. How did we do on that?
It was fine. I just couldn't get my shoe to turn on.
The shoes on these floors down here. And it's not the same as the stage, and I don't know why. But all right, let's try it again. Now, if you feel more comfortable getting into your reverse lunge first and then doing this, fine. Otherwise, we're going to work on balance a little bit. So we are going to place one elbow inside the other. Inhale, one, two, three. On the exhalation, slide the foot back. Inhale. Push the knee through, turn to the chair, extend the leg, opposite arm goes over the chair, hold one, two, three, four, five, six, exhale, elbow to knee, and again, stretch, one, two, three, four, five, six, exhale, elbow to knee, and come down to center. Position and legs apart, inhale up, exhale down. All right, that looked pretty good actually. We need to try lifting more in the core and upper body. So when you're here in these positions, really lift here. Same thing here, keep the lift. Extend the leg and bend over. So in other words, you don't want to slump down this way. All right, now we try the opposite arm. Elbow, elbow in. Inhale, one, two, three. Exhale, outside leg goes back, down, two, three. Press up, turn to the chair, extend the leg, reach with the opposite arm, two, three, four, five, six, exhale, elbow to knee, and stretch again, opposite arm and leg, one, two, three, four, five, six, exhale, foot down on the floor, come back to center position. All right, let's try it again. Elbow in, turn the chair, extend the leg, opposite arm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Exhale, elbow to knee. And come down to center position. Come front, legs apart. Inhale, up. And exhale, down. All right, so now we're going to try our triangle pose. So you're going to base the foot against the back leg of the chair. The foot is turned out. All right, move the other one apart, heels even. This toe is forward. And we're going to press the hip to the side. Remove the hand from the chair, slide down the leg, lift the arm, and if you can make it down to the ankle in triangle, very good. Inhale, coming up to center position, and down. Let's try it one more time. You may want to adjust your feet a little bit here. All right, so one foot is against the back leg of the chair. The other foot straight. We push the hip to the side. Remove the hand from the chair, and we're going to slide down with one arm, up with the other till we get to the ankle. Pull the chest back. Don't pull the shoulder forward. You want it reaching back. And inhale up. Exhale down, hand on chair. Foot from the chair, toes in, heels in, toes, heels, and together. All right, let's try it on the other side. It looked pretty good, except for when you're down there, I want that chest here and not here. Okay, so that's, I would rather have you not go so far down than to lose the stretch in here. All right, so. Inside leg, those on the against the back leg of the chair, foot turned out. Heels are even, use the line on the floor. Toe is straight. We push the hips to the side. Remove the hand, now slide down the leg. Only go as far as you can before you lose this upper position. Slide down to the ankle, lift the arm. And exhale, coming back up. Good. You can see from one side to the other, sometimes the one isn't so good, so that's an area you know you need to work on in flexibility. And reach down toward the end, lift up with the arm. Exhale, come back up. Hand on chair, toes in, heels in, toes in, heels in. Inhale up, exhale down. All right, so now we're going to do a warrior pose. We'll do some variations on it. So you're going to have a seat and turn the body completely to the side so that only one hip is, cheek is on the chair, the other one is off. You want that leg back here. We lift the outside arm up and hold. Now relax the shoulders down. Now lift the shoulder to the ear. Lift the other arm up into warrior one. Exhale, we're going to bend forward from the waist. If you feel the hamstring of the leg engaging, inhale up. Now, as you exhale to the side, arms down, we are going to move the foot forward here. This foot will be straight, other foot turned out to the side. Turn palm up, bring it into the thigh, slide down the leg, and again, reach for the instep of the foot, lifting up. Inhale, come up. Burst into warrior three. Again, fingers wide, press, two, three, four. And hands down. All right, now we're going to try that combo to the other side. So one cheek on the chair, body totally toward the side. One leg back comfortably. You don't want to overstretch the hip flexor. Inhale, one arm up. Relax the shoulder down. Inhale, other arm up. Relax as you exhale. Shoulders should be down. Inhale. Exhale, bend forward and feel the hamstring of the other leg engage. Inhale, up. Arms coming down to the side on exhale. Warrior two, you're going to turn the foot to the side, the other foot straight out, heels even, flip one palm up, inside thigh all the way down, and try to reach the instep, inhale, coming back up. Burst into warrior three. Exhale, spread the fingers. One, two, three, four, and exhale down. All right, so now we're going to try that threesome standing. Or you can remain in the chair. All right, so we stand, we turn sideways. This one is straight ahead, forward, heels even, turn, inhale, lift, warrior one. Exhale, bend from the waist. Inhale, warrior two, both feet turned out to the side. Slide down, bend one knee as you reach. Inhale up. Burst into warrior three. Exhale. Fingers wide, palms back. Two, three, four. And down. Toes in, heels in. All right, now the other side. Exhale. Forward, keeping arms at waist level. All right, warrior two. Feet are both turned out. And we're going to bend one knee. We're going to come down. We're going to lift the arm. And come back up to center position. Burst, warrior three. And press back. One, two, three, four. And toes in, heels in, toes in, heels in. Okay, how did that feel? Yeah, it does. It's a marvelous stretcher for any number of areas of the body. Okay, so now we're going to do a combination sumo wrestler with a oblique stretch. stretch. So you're going to come to the side of your chair. All right, we're going to lift the leg, circle it, fist, pound. Now come toward the other one. You're up on the toe here and stretch. And exhale down. Inhale. Hips are way to the back here. Shift and push through. And center. One more time. Inhale. Bring it into center. Stretch. And exhale down. Very good. Let's try that on the opposite side. All right. Ready? Inhale. Make a fist. Exhale. Hips to the back. Now lean toward the chair. Stretch that oblique muscle. And come back to center position. Good. Again. Inhale. And reach. And exhale. All right, so let's now do some balance poses. So we're going to start with tree pose. Modification one. Leg to the side, lift in the core, nice and straight. Heel over to the ankle. Arm up, when you have your balance, other arm. Very good. Exhale down. And now we're going to do salamander eyes again. And see if you can hold the pose. Shift eyes only to the left. Shift right, look up, eyes down. Now we're going to try circling and eyes left, look up, eyes right, eyes down. Good, we held balance on that, wonderful. All right. Tree pose modification two on side of calf. Inhale up. Arms up and hold. Place the thumbs together and place thumbs into the heart chakra. Release and down. Pretty good. There's a little moving around there, but we did well. Lay out to the side, and if you can, bring the hand on the ankle, place the foot inside the thigh. Inhale up into modification. Three, full tree pose. Good, excellent. And down. All right. Let's try it on the other side. Last year we couldn't even get the leg up for tree pose three. All right, now lay to the side. Bring the foot across the ankle. Inhale up. Other arm up. Thumbs together. Come down to the heart chakra. Thumbs into the heart. Eyes, salamander. Shift right, shift left, eyes shift up to the ceiling, down to the floor. And again, making a circle, shift right, look up, shift left, look down, and release, back to center. All right, modification two, lay goes on the side of the calf. Inhale up. And you have your balance together here. And thumbs come into the heart chakra. Hold. Release. And full tree pose. Lift. Bring the hand to the ankle. Bring it into the inner thigh. Hold. Ah, that wasn't so good. Let's try it again. Lift. In. It's hard with these tights that slide. Up, here we go. Pull the tummy in. Pull the tummy in. That's it. And exhale down. Very good. You've got a nice turnout in the pelvis area. Great turnout. Actually, that is a very good body type for yoga. I don't have it. A lot of people don't, or we don't really turn out like that. But you work toward it and work within your limits, you will still get benefits. Okay, so let's have a seat, and we're going to stretch the hips now. So we lift, take one hand on the ankle, bring it over the other leg. And just even this position, you can start feeling the stretch on the outside hip and the IT band on the side of the leg. All right, place the hands inside thigh. Exhale, back of throat like you're fogging a window. Press gently, pulsing. Right hand on ankle and press the chest as close as you can to the thigh, and that's an even deeper stretch. And come back to center position. These are very good to do in the morning when you stretch the hip area. Your walking ability, getting out of bed, is just so much more fluid than otherwise. All right, remove the leg from the thigh, press it down, lift, hand on ankle, take the leg over the other thigh, hands on the inside, exhale, back of throat like fogging the window. And now, hand on ankle and press chest to thigh. And come back up to center position. And take that leg off the other one and press it down on the floor. Now we're going to sit forward in the front of the chair. And we are going to work the upper and lower abdominal here. So we are going to lift the right leg, spread the arms out, and you are going to come back four, up four. One, two, three, four. Inhale, up. Two, three, four. Exhale, back. Two, three, four. Inhale, up. Two, three, four, back, one, two, three, four, inhale, up, two, three, four, and down. Now, if that bothers your thigh, if your quad is not strong enough to do that, just keep the foot on the floor. Otherwise, lift, take it back, two, three, four, up, two, three, four, back, two, three, up, two, three, four, back, two, three, four, up, two, three, four, exhale down. And we'll have our close, cross the feet in Sukhasana pose. Interlace the fingers, place them on the thighs, close the eyes. Picture the color purple on the top of the head. That chakra governs spirituality. Inhale, exhale. Move down to the throat area surrounded with the color blue. This governs your communications. Inhale. Exhale. Move down to the heart chakra, surround that area with green, the color of empathy, love. Inhale, exhale. Move down to the solar plexus, color yellow. Let's release any tension we're holding there. Inhale, exhale. And now bathe the lower chakra in the color red for energy and passion. And inhale. Exhale. Uncross the feet. Inhale up. And our affirmation for today is, I am wealthy in health and spirit. I am wealthy in health and spirit. Again, I am wealthy in health and spirit. I am wealthy in health and spirit. Inhale up, nose over toes to stand. And exhale, Om Shanti. Thank you for joining me this morning, everyone. Remember, signing up for classes, if you're coming in person, March 20th, you start signing up for whatever classes you want. That way your name will be on the list. Check your name. If it's not there, just leave it off. Stay with me. Oh, 10 o'clock, I'm sorry, we're not virtual for arthritis prevention and agility, but you're welcome to come in and join us. It's a fun class and you'll see measurable results. Tomorrow, 9 a.m., TheraBand, and if you haven't, check out some of the new moves we're doing. 10 a.m., Senior Strength and Balance. Have a good day and thank you for tuning in.